For more than 30 years, Ian Paisley has given loud voice to Loyalist fears, as no other can. Whenever there were suspicions that Downing Street and Dublin were doing deals, Paisley roared out the warning.
We are opposed to a united Ireland! We will not have a united Ireland! Yeah!
Northern Ireland's Prime Minister, Brian Faulkner, had just signed an agreement with the Irish Republic.
I say to the Dublin government, Mr. Faulkner says its hands across the border to Dublin. I say if they don't behave themselves in the south, it will be shots across the border.
But a few months later, it was not shots, but bombs across the border, although Paisley had nothing to do with them. The UVF planted three car bombs in the south. There were no warnings. 33 people were killed, 26 in Dublin, the biggest loss of life in a single day in the whole of the conflict. One victim was preparing for her wedding.
She was 6 weeks off being married, making all her preparations. Her wedding dress, her wedding cake, presents in the house. The last thing Horton I done was wrote out her invitation cards, 120 invitation cards, on the Thursday night before she was killed.
Why did the UVF bomb Dublin?
I think what they were doing was returning the serve. You know,
returning the serve?
Yeah, well that's what they would perhaps say. I'm not advocating bombing anywhere. What I'm saying to you is that what we had witnessed here was the killing of our people. Now, do you know how it feels? I think that was the sense. Do you know how it feels?
Returning the serve, slaughtering 26 innocent people?
You ask me a question, I give you an answer in determining why people do things.
The slaughter was carried out by two UVF units, one from the Shankill Road and one from Portadown. The bombers were never charged.
All I can say is for myself and my wife, and I'd say the children too, that there's not a day goes by where we don't think of that child.